फाइव सेकेंड, टू सेकेंड, रेडी। बींग अग्रीव्ड द प्राइवेट रेस्पोंडेंट्स फाइल्ड आ रिविजन बिफोर द डिप्टी डायरेक्टर ऑफ कंसोलिडेशन अंडर सेक्शन 48 ऑफ द एक्ट 1953 हु वाइड हिज जजमेंट डेटेड 25 जून 2002 अपहेल्ड द ऑर्डर ऑफ द सेटलमेंट ऑफिसर ऑफ कंसोलिडेशन ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट आ प्रिलिमिनरी डिक्री इज अ फाइनल डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ द राइट्स ऑफ द पार्टीज इन रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी सॉट टू बी पार्टीशन्ड। इट इज ऑल्सो अपीलिएबल बट नो सच अपील वॉज फाइल्ड बाई द पेटिशनर हियर इन दैट इज रेस्पोंडेंट्स बिफोर द रिविजनल कोर्ट ऑन द एलिगेशन ऑफ फ्रॉड द कोर्ट परस्यूड द रिकॉर्ड्स एंड फाउंड दैट देयर वॉज नो प्लीडिंग containing requisite denial of thumb impression nor the presence of the concerned in the court etc nor evidence to prove any such fraud. The revisional court relied upon the decision of the Supreme Court reported in AIR 1995 SC 2493 Moolchand and others versus Deputy Director Consolidation and others to hold that a preliminary decree passed in a suit for partition under section 176 binds the parties even if those proceedings do not result in a final decree if the said preliminary decree is not challenged in appeal. Therefore, the preliminary decree dated 1st January 1986 passed on the basis of compromise which had been duly proved was binding upon the petitioners and also operated as estoppel and principle of acquiescence also applied. The contention of learned counsel for petitioner is that no such compromise was entered into with the private respondents and he had no knowledge whatsoever about the said preliminary decree. Once the suit awaited the preliminary decree could not have been appealed as any proceedings could only take place before the consolidation authorities. Plea of fraud was taken before the consolidation authorities which was found to be correct by the settlement officer consolidation and rightly so. There was no reason for the petitioner to enter into a compromise relinquishing one third share and accepting one sixth share of the holding but the revisional court without appreciating these aspects of the matter has erred on facts and law in upturning the judgment of the settlement officer of consolidation causing prejudice to the petitioner. Sri V.K. Singh, Learned Counsel appearing for private respondents has relied upon the decision of the Supreme Court in the case of Moolchand to contend that preliminary decree prepared in regular suit under section 176 for partition division of share which had not been appealed was binding upon the parties and had to be given effect in consolidation proceedings between the parties. Therefore, the revisional court had adopted a correct approach in deciding the matter. He contended that there was no pleading whatsoever of fraud, nor was it ever proved. On the question of variance of shares contrary to what the petitioner was legally entitled, the pedigree being admitted to the parties, he placed reliance upon the judgment of this court report in Srimati Manraji versus Deputy Director of Consolidation and Others 2010 ADJ 249. On a perusal of the order of revisional court, it is found that it has considered relevant aspects of the matter and issues involved therewith on the question of compromise dated 1 March 1986 and its veracity it has held in detailed that in the objections filed before the consolidation officer, the petitioner herein never denied the thumb impressions on the compromise filed nor their presence on the relevant date. On a perusal of the record, it found the thumb impression of the petitioner on the compromise as also that of other parties, as also the fact that based on such compromise, the subdivisional magistrate Sandila had passed a decree. It also found that thumb impression of the petitioner had been verified by his advocate just as those of other parties had been verified by their counsel, and at the back of the compromise, the court of subdivisional magistrate concerned had made his endorsement and signature. Therefore, it found the contention of the petitioner herein that no such compromise was presented before the presiding officer to be factually incorrect.